Hello everyone and welcome to this video by Beta CAE Systems. Today we're going to demonstrate the latest developments in Meta version 21 regarding exporting files. We'll start with some developments in exporting U3D PDFs. If we load some results in this model here, I'll switch the fringe bar on and change the range to say 250 for the maximum value. And then I will create some annotations on elements using the advanced filter. So if I choose annotations on element, and then I create annotations on say the maximum 5, I've got my annotations created, so I can explode them around the model, change their precision, and add background based on the values. Now, if I adjust this a bit and keep just one part visible, I can go on into saving this as a U3D PDF. So from File, Save As, I select U3D PDF from my file type list. And then when I open this, I can see that my annotations are saved, and when I rotate and spin the model around, these follow it and are always parallel to the screen so that they can be easily read. Next, we have now supported a new file format in exporting, which is GLB and GLTF. GLB is the binary format, so let's have a look at this model here again. If we apply some rendering materials to it to make it look nicer, so we'll apply some blue color for the bike frame. We want some rubber material for the tires and for the seat and the handles perhaps. The chains can be steel. And lastly, let's say some black plastic for the pedals. Okay, so we've got our model nice looking. And now we will go to File, Save As, and select the GLTF and GLB format. GLB is the binary format which can also be embedded in a PowerPoint as long as it's Office 365 or 2019. But we can open with a normal 3D viewer our export here, and we see that it looks pretty impressive, and it's a good way of exporting and sharing models with our colleagues. Contour plot visualization is also supported, so if we turn the fringe bar on for some parts and then we export this again as GLTF or GLP, again when we open using a 3D viewer, we see that we've got the contour plot saved and shown as well. Moving on to reading files in Meta, we have expanded the possibility to read results from compressed MetaDBs using the same interface and reading options as if we were directly loading Meta-calculated results from the solver files for ANSYS, PERMAS, OpenFOAM, and StarCCM+. It is reminded that this functionality was already available in previous versions for LSDyna, Nastran, Abacus, and PAMCrush. Let's have a look at an example from ANSYS. The scalar results are now grouped appropriately instead of being listed in a big and not very easy to handle list. In addition, the grouping and stress invariant calculation is now based on solver-specific element formulation, which means that if we choose to read the von Mises stress, for instance, the result that we will get is the same as if we were asking Meta to calculate this directly from the solver file. Continuing with advancements in the area of project files, we can now use the filtering mechanism introduced in the previous major version in order to scan and load specific entities from a project file. If we head this project file, for example, we see that we've got quite a few windows. In one of them, we've got the whole model with the cut planes, and the rest of the windows include just one part per window. Now, let's say that we wanted to work on one or two of these parts and not all of them. We now have the option to scan and filter what we want to read instead of reading the whole project file. We can do this either from the Read Results card or from the Project Contents browser. If we create a fresh meta and then go to File, Project Contents, we can select our project file. The contents are listed in the window. We can see the parts that we have, the models, the cut planes. Now, if we press the filter button, we can filter the contents. So for instance, we can filter and choose just the windows that include a specific ID. Now, if we type meta, we can select the MetaPost window, which had the full model. Then make sure to select the model that we want to load in our windows. And perhaps from the three cut planes, only select one. And if we press read, we see that we've got just the three windows that we asked for. And it's much easier to work if we wanted to isolate a couple of parts and just work on them instead of loading, let's say, a project file which had one window for all the parts of a big model. This brings us to an end regarding new features in the area of exporting files. Stay tuned for more videos on other disciplines. Thanks for watching!